time. Today is a great day on which we have to rejoice because in our country, churches have been reopened. Churches have been now brought to us that we can meet together as a family of God in the house of God. The readings of today, like other readings, do not conform to the wave in this world. Do not conform to the reality that churches are opened and therefore let us only be rejoicing. Let us only have the prayer of thanking God. No, the readings still remain to help us grow in faith, love, and charity. And above all, to understand God and what He wants of us, which will eventually lead us to eternal life. The readings in a special way of this Sunday focus on the issue of ecumenism. Can we recognize, can we acknowledge that the Spirit of the Lord cannot be limited? It cannot be set against a certain boundary. But God chooses as He wills, and He sends His Spirit to anyone, even those who are outside a known institution, outside a known people. The first reading gives us Moses. When Moses prayed, the Spirit came from Moses to the 70 elders, but there were two others who were in their tents. The Spirit of the Lord also went to them, and by the power of that Spirit, they came out speaking of the Lord. Like most of the Christians do, other denominations which are not part of us, we tend to fight them. We tend to hold that grudge such that we are the best. These ones are not ours, therefore they are false. The readings of today emphasize when other people are doing anything in the name of God, let us not fight them, because those who are not against us, those who are not fighting us, they are for us. And therefore, we should encourage them. And therefore, we should support them. And therefore, we should be thankful. This is the same that we have heard in the gospel. When John comes to Jesus, says, we have found other people preaching in your name, but they are not part of us. Should we stop them? Jesus says, no. That is ecumenism. That we as Christians, as everyone preaches the word of God, as everyone preaches Jesus Christ, may we not be taken up by the hate, by the envy, to stop them. But can we encourage one another? That is the call of today's readings. However, today's readings still call us to mind. We should not take it for granted that whoever preaches in the name of Jesus is a true prophet. There are so many prophets who have taken on, I preach in the name of God, I have seen God, I have heard God. But still, should we leave Christ and go to them? No. Take note of the false prophets. Take note of everyone who says, I preach in the name of God. Because many preach inward, but downwards, they are doing the contrary. As the readings today are calling us to realize this reality in our lives and in the world today, we as Christians are called upon to think of ecumenism. We thank the Uganda Joint Christian Council. In a special way, the unity that Jesus talks about, the realization that the Holy Spirit is not tied to a certain institution, comes out clearly in this institution. Because in them, we are able to see the leaders of Christian denominations coming together. They acknowledge each other as leaders and true Christians. Why? Because we realize the Spirit of the Lord is open to everyone. And therefore, on this Sunday, can we pray for them? Can we pray for the work they are doing, the Uganda Joint Christian Council, such that we too as a nation, we too as Christians, one day we may come back as Jesus prayed for us, being one. May we one day come together and truly we are one people, one Christianity, one faith before God. The readings today, on another hand, they call upon us to reflect on the possessions we have in this world, the wealth we have. Indeed, the wealth we have in this world are a vanity. And many Christians and many people have resorted to accumulating wealth, to accumulating goods, to accumulating money. Many have exploited their brothers. The second reading is emphasizing, what gain will it be? You gain everything, but in the end, you lose eternal life. And you as a Christian, as you do that, you don't think of your brother, you don't think of your sister, and you accumulate wealth. As a Christian, the wealth you are accumulating illegally, the wealth you are accumulating out of sinful ways, it is the same wealth that is going to bear witness to you before God that indeed you didn't work for eternal life. The same way Jesus is questioning us, may we not be taken up by the possessions of this world, whether wealth or even parties of our bodies. If it is the eye, pluck it out. If it is the hand, cut it off. What gain will it be to lose heaven? And because you had both legs, because you had both hands. However, the gospel is not calling us to the physical cutting off of our body parts, but to the spiritual one. If your eye looks at things that are not good before God, instead of plucking it out, train your eye not to look there. If your hand takes things that are not yours, if your hand is leading you into sin, don't cut it off literally. Stop it from doing that is what is evil. If it is by your feet that you travel to go and steal, to go and into adultery, to go into rumor, Jesus is not telling us, cut the legs off, because when God created us, he saw man in his own image, and man was perfect. There is no moment where God would want any human being to lose any part of his body. But he's questioning us, may the parts of our bodies not lead us into losing eternal life. May we use them wisely, not to use eternal life. The Lord be with you. Happy trials and tribulations.